Yeah, this is one of the best solutions that that we have to have an auto-sustainable, safe environment. So this is our mission of the Farm of Consciousness. Our mission is to create an auto-sustainable living environment where we can all prosper and grow spiritually and on all levels of life together. And our vision statement is to offer people a happy, healthy, and sustainable way of living through education using techniques and teachings that are in the harmony with nature. Right, and now we're gonna start with presenting you the property and the whole plan that we have created so far. So once again, guys, this plan is not 100% fixed, and we are still working on improving it. So at the end, very important, I want you to share your thoughts, ideas, and ask your questions on how we can improve the plan that we have created, and also expand the vision. Right, so at the moment we are in the buying the property stage. I've seen this property about, I don't know, 6 months ago, and I've been visiting it for about 5 times. And the thing is that every time I'm going to see that property, I see another part of it. It's like, it's so big, it's 9 hectares, which is 90,000 square meters. And it's absolutely huge. Is I'm gonna share with you in a moment the whole idea, and I want to be fully transparent with you with everything that is happening, with the costs, with when we are going to purchase the property. So we are very clear and transparent with all the plans that we have. So the plan with the house was to buy it in about 6 months. The landlady that owns the property is supposed to finish all the paperwork in 2 weeks' time, and she's been working on all the paperwork and legal documents in order to be able to sell the house. She's been working for the last 2 years, and in 2 weeks it's going to be ready. And our plan was to make like a pre-contract in order to buy the property, but she said she doesn't want to create the pre-contract, where basically we were supposed to give her an upfront payment, like a deposit, and after 6 months to pay the full amount. And she said that she doesn't want that because she also has other clients that are interested into buying the property. But so far we are like on the number one in the list of the buyers. I made sure that I created a good connection with the landlady, and she is happy to sell it to us. We have at the moment some sort of small challenge, I may say, that as I told you, we were supposed to gather all the funds in 6 months, but we have about 1 month to gather all the funds for the property. We're gonna make it happen. We have a proper plan, and we're going to buy the property for sure. So the next step after buying the property would be to create the permaculture design, where Leopold shared with you why it's important to create the permaculture. Our vision is basically to create enough food that we can feed even 100 people per year without any problems, without buying any extra food from outside sources. So this is very important for us to create the permaculture auto-sustainable. So that is the main point. We're gonna start probably from this winter and start working on the land. The next point is to refurbish the house and the hostel facilities, which we call it actually farmstel. You're gonna see it in a moment. I'm gonna take you on a special tour in our community house. Then the next step is to, and by the way, with the, I'm going to share with you basically what's in with the house and with the hostel, because we have two buildings on the land. Then the next step would be to set up the glamping area, which we have created, which we have found a perfect spot for it, which basically this glamping area is going to produce us an income, so we are auto-sustainable, we don't need to work, and we have also created this system where you can benefit financially from this project, and you don't need to work or to I don't know, make a living outside of us, if I can put it like that. The next point is to start creating events, workshops, seminars, and grow the community. We're also going to create retreats and different teachings environments where all members of community can come forward and create different workshops, events where we bring people from outside and teach them about the permaculture and different workshops. And then the next, the final point would be to become fully independent on resources. So we are fully independent from the government. We're going to have our own water, our own food, our own electricity and heating resources. So we're going to be 100% auto-sustainable. Right. Let's go further. So here is the house, actually. Probably most of you have seen it. What you can see here is perhaps, I don't know, 5% of the total property of how big it is. So this is what you can see basically here. This is like a small portion that you can see in this image. This is the house. It is a huge house with about, on the second floor, it has three huge bedrooms, a huge living room, a kitchen, two bathrooms. The whole house actually has two bathrooms. And on the ground floor, it has two bedrooms with kitchen and the basement with a toilet inside, which you will see in a moment. We also have a spring water here. But yeah, I want to take you actually on a proper tour on Google Maps. Right, so this is basically the place. All right, let it charge. So this is our house. This is where the house is. This is where the picture was taken. And here on the back of the house, we have the farm still, which I'm gonna share with you in a moment. What is the plan with it, and how we're gonna share? We're gonna create basically some sort of a hostel environment that can fit even 20, 30 people in good conditions. Right. So. So here we have a proper road that you can come with any car. If I scroll out a little bit, you will see that this is the main village here. And we have different shops and facilities over there. And it's about 30 minutes away from Brad and about, I think, 45 minutes away from Deva in Hunedoara. So let me go back to the place. All right, here it is. Right, so let me give you a little brief history about the house. The house was owned by two rich families, two boyer, if you know what boyer means. And basically, there were two big families living on the top floor upstairs of the house, and downstairs where those two rooms I told you that there are were living the servants. If they're called like that. Yeah, and basically this whole family, these two families, the neighbors told us that they were growing food only in this small part of the land. As you can see, there is a fence around, and they used to grow vegetables and feed the whole two families only with this small plot of land. And this huge land over here that we have, which is all ours, they used to grow hay to feed the animals there. Also, on the top of the, just here next to the road, there is a river called the Ply River, which has a proper water flow. And we also have another river on the other side of the property, which is right through here, where is a forest. So we have basically two rivers on our property, and we also have a spring water right here, which has very good water and is going with big pressure in the house. So let me actually draw on this picture exactly what is the plan with the house. Right, so this is the house with those five bedrooms, and here is the farm stall that I'm gonna tell you what we're gonna do. And basically, this is the small garden that they used to grow vegetables there. And this is the whole land that there is, basically. So let me make sure that I cover it properly. So now it goes like this. So this is 90,000 square meters. Right, so this is like the whole property. And here, if I go to Google Maps, here on the front of the property is a huge forest where we have three quarters of a hectare of forest. So basically we have forest over here, we have forest on the top of the property, and we have forest right here, which is part of our property, and wood obviously that we can use. Right, so let me zoom in. So this is basically where we want to create the permaculture on this plot of land over here, which is absolutely huge. I think easily can feed 100 people because it's absolutely huge. And we also have the river over here to help us to water the vegetables, but we don't really need to, because with permaculture we don't need to water it. So this is the perfect and best environment for growing the plants, the food. And on the top of it, right here on this area, this is the housing area, basically, where all the members of community are going to be able to build their own little houses in the future. But in the meantime, you're going to have access to the farm still facilities that we're going to create. Right, so here is the spring water, as I mentioned, and this is a huge, beautiful plateau where we're gonna build the glamping, where basically we're gonna put different structure like A-frames or different small little wood houses to create like a hotel environment, where basically we're going to use it to generate income and to bring people from outside and share them different experiences and opportunities on the community. Right, so here on the top we have, as you saw, a little forest. And here on the top of the property, we have an incredible mountain hiking pathway, which is absolutely incredible. It goes for like 4 hours on the top of a hill, which is like a mountain. It has a 700 meters altitude, and it's an absolutely incredible view. If you saw Leopold or my stories lately, when we've been there last week, you could see how beautiful this area is. And we have access from the property. This is the only access actually to go there and to go through that mountain hike, where basically it's going to be one of the attractions. And this land, we don't have a plan for it yet, but we definitely going to use it in the best possible way. Right, so let me go back to the presentation. Right, yeah, so this is the house from the front, and on the back there we have a huge other structure, which is in form of U. I'm gonna share with you some videos very soon with it. Right, let's go forward. So how can you be part of us? Because put this here so you can see all the details. So as a partner, what are the benefits that you will get if you want to be part of our community? Because obviously this community does not exist without you. I mean, humans and the partners, you know, the people that are part of the community are the most important resources that we have. Because without you, nothing is going to happen. So as a partner, you will get the following benefits. You will get 250 square meters for your own house, where I show you where is the housing area, with a legal contract for the land. So basically, you're going to get a legal contract once you invest with us. You're going to have a legal document in the house area where you can build your own house. You're also going to have five shares of the income shared as profits, where basically I'm going to show you in a moment what and how are we going to manage all the resources and the funds. As I told you, we are fully transparent, and we're going to share with you all the plans. If you want to change or improve the plan or our strategy in any way, you can share at the end. You can also get access to the to live in the farmstead area where I told you that we're gonna create about 20 to 30 sleeping beds until you build your own house, obviously, or if you want to stay just there, we're gonna work it out. Access to the land, food, water, events, retreats, workshops, and festivals. You know, we all the time, probably every weekend, we're gonna have some events happening there. And you're also gonna have access to all holistic educational space to learn and grow. Because one of our principles that we want to implement is we want to create an environment where we can develop ourselves personally and spiritually. And we're also gonna have probably like a spiritual practice where you can take part of as optional. And if you want to be part of the community, the starting point is 5,000 euros package, which is only for the first five partners. And after that, this package will then become 8K. Basically, with 5,000 euros, you will get a ticket to live for the rest of your life in such a beautiful community, in a paradise. And you are basically set for life, and with only such a small investment, where, yeah, basically you're gonna have access to all these facilities and benefits. And if you want to invest even more, I mean, if you want, after you buy this this package, you can also sell it after that. But if you want to invest more, if you want to be more involved with us, you can purchase a VIP package of 20k plus euros. And if you want to buy this package, you have to make a three-way call with me, Leopold, and all the rest of the leaders. So once again, I want to be fully transparent with you and to share basically how we're going and what we're going to do with the money and what is the cost of the full investment. So to buy the property is going to cost 70k. I know it's a big price. As we knew the price before, the neighbors told us that the price for the house was 50k about 3 years ago when the woman started to work on the paperwork, but she invested a lot of money into the paperwork, she said, and now she has other clients that are willing to pay 70k. Because to be honest, if you really get a proper idea of how big and full of resources the property is, would, I think, in my opinion, worth even 100k euros. So next month, basically, we need to buy the property and we're going to come with a solution. Once again, we don't have all the funds at the moment liquid. I started to sell my apartment and to gather all the funds together. Because we're going all in, but we don't have yet all the funds available because the woman, the landlady, gave us a short notice, if I can say so. All right. So the next point is we have to invest at least, I think, 10k euros in development for the permaculture design, where we basically want to build even a greenhouse. On the Christmas, when it's all snow outside, I want to come up with a big hand of salads and stuff like that. So we also gonna create an environment where we can grow food all time of the year. So we have to invest at least a 10K, and this 10K obviously is gonna feed us for the rest of our life. Then we have to invest about 10k in the refurbishment of the house. The house is almost refurbished. It has proper windows, like thermopans. I don't know how they call it in English. And it's not a big, really big investment that we need to do there. But obviously, we want to create a proper environment where people feel safe, comfortable, and to feel like it is a cozy environment, you know, an environment of abundance. So we don't want to really create rough conditions for you. The next point is we need about 15k for the refurbishment of the farmstead, where we will create about 20 to 30 spaces for people to sleep, with kitchen area, with living room and all the facilities comfortably, and another 20k for the glamping area. But this glamping area probably is going to happen in 2023, I think, because next year we want to make sure that we have the development of the permaculture, which is the main important point, as you saw in the timeline. And then we want to invest in the refurbishment of the house and the farmstead. So glamping area is the last point. Right, so this is how we are going to manage the money and the priorities. So this is the plan that we came up with, and we think is very well balanced. So 50% of all income that we get from all the glamping area, the events, the retreats, the workshops, the festivals that we're going to do there, 50% of all the income are going to the development of the infrastructure, because there is always room to grow, and there is so much on the top, on the other side of the property that we can develop. So yeah, we think that 50% is a good amount to go back into the infrastructure. 50% of the other income will be shared among the members this way. So we have created 20 shares as in a company, and depending on your investment, you will receive your income. So as you saw on the package, for example, if you buy this 5K package, you're gonna get 5 shares of the income. So you're not only going to get a place to stay, a place to buy a house, and a place and all the resources to live comfortably. You're also going to get some shares and some passive income for the rest of your life, as long as we're going to have money in our society, because I'm not sure if in 5 years we really going to have this financial system. Right. So basically, this is the presentation, and now very important, I want to hear your opinions, your thoughts, and your questions regarding the plan that we made together. So if you don't want to speak, you can put your questions in the chat box, or if you want you can unmute yourself and share your thoughts, your ideas. This is very important. Your feedback is very important, and your thoughts and ideas are very valuable. So yeah, please share.
Can I share another perspective of of the land, because people need to see it also from above? Can you see it?
Oh yeah, I forgot to share the videos. Yeah, oh, good one. Go for it.
So yeah, I hope you can hear this. This is on the fourth I don't know how to.
Da, aici? Aluni?
Până vezi cu ochii în vale, nu vezi cu telefonul, nu?
Nu vezi cu telefonul?
Am înțeles.
Dar până în partea asta e V-ul ăsta de pădure, nu?
Da, și V-ul ăla de pădure, nu?
So that is the forest.
Al patrulea deal. Al patrulea deal de urcat. Al patrulea cât vedem cu ochii.
Unitate de măsură cât vezi cu ochii. Unitatea de măsură cât vezi cu ochii.
Și încă unul în partea
aia.
Are you sharing the screen? Yeah.
Yeah. That's it. That's my video.
Well, anyway, I have some more videos, so let me share, because I have them.
First, maybe they have also questions. And people.
Yeah, in the meantime, you can ask the questions, and I will, hold on, let me, because I have pictures even from inside the house. So this is the view from the middle of the property. And this is the front of the property over there, where you can see this is the garden where we're going to create the permaculture, and this is the house. This is the front of the house, and this is the and that is, hold on, and that, and this is the farmstead over here, right there. It is a huge building. I mean, you can't see what is behind, but it's a huge building. Right, so let me show you some more videos. So there is a video where I'm going inside the house. This is the backyard. It is very hard to see it from one place. We have lots of trees on the ground, on the land.
They're all fruit trees mostly.
Yeah.
Apple trees, pear trees.
This is the spring. This is Alfonso. We were... there is another pipe from this spring. I mean, obviously the spring has to be repaired, but there is another pipe underground that goes straight into the house and into a big tank of water. So we are collecting a lot of water there. This is again in front of the house. There is, should be a video where I'm going inside the house. Yeah, so this is where the servants were living. So this is the ground floor of the building. So as you can see, it's a huge room, another room on the left. This is the second room where I suppose is a kitchen. And we also have this basement. It's a huge basement.
Can you make it the full screen?
No.
Oh, okay.
And there is a toilet in the basement, very strange. So let me show you inside the house. So this is the living area. It's a huge room. And here we have three huge bedrooms. This is one of them. And this is a little hallway. And the walls are very thick. Yeah, it's like 60 centimeters wide. And this is another room that I don't know exactly what it is. As you can see, the people have started to do some refurbishments there. This is one of the bathrooms. Obviously, we need to refurbish everything here. And this is one of the bedrooms. It is a huge bedroom. All right, so let's go on the other side. So this is just one half of the house, and this the other half is even bigger. So here we have a little hallway. I suppose you can see properly, we have view, right? And this is, hold on. Not sure why you cannot hear. You can't hear, isn't it? Right, so this is one of the, this is the back yard. This is one of the rooms. This is the second room. It's a huge room. And on the other side, we have a kitchen and another bathroom. All right, let me see if I have other, no, that's it. Cool. So now I want to hear your questions. Once again, you can put the questions in the chat box or you can unmute yourself.
Okay, so the part with the 20 beds where the people are living until they're building the houses, it's in that house or in another facility?
No, it's next to the house. But you can also live in the actual house. Where we also gonna create like a hostel environment, but it's just next to the house, and you also have water and all the facilities there on the.
Yeah, so I saw the counter, and you also have electric current, so it's pretty good.
Yeah, we have all the resources, but we're probably gonna keep the electricity for 1 year if they're gonna give us electricity, because I don't know if you heard that. We're gonna experience some blackouts this winter.
I saw in all the Europe. At some
yeah,
point.
Yeah. Things are getting serious in the society. Yeah, very good question. Yeah, it's just next to the house. You can even come with the car inside. So it's very close.
And with all the, I think when you told us that there are two big buildings behind it in the backyard. There are two barns, if I'm not wrong.
Two barns. No, we have two houses basically on the land. It's that big house that I just showed you. And you also have the big farm still where we're gonna create 20-30 beds.
Those farms still look they were looking like barns.
What is a barn?
Barn is a place where you keep
barns. Shura.
Ah, shura. Like, all right, like a shed. Yeah, it is basically a shed, but it is a huge.
It's a shed built from an ex house, actually.
Okay.
So the structure is for a house that is inside. The shed is the exterior side, but inside is concrete, actually.
Yeah. Okay, so you have a structure with concrete, not only with
wood. Exactly.
Yeah. Because that structure, it is basically a U. A building, and what you saw are basically the two sides, but on the back of it we have a concrete structure, and on the front we have a wood structure, where basically that wood structure we can build it with concrete. I mean, not with concrete, we're going to use healthy materials from the environment.
It's concrete with stones, so it's also it's combined.
Yeah.
I want to be an icebreaker, so other people, if you have questions, go ahead, please.
Thank you.
Yes, guys. Yeah. Any questions that you may have, or if something was not really clear, you can ask.
Or any advice that you might.
Or idea? Yeah. Idea for.
Guys, I'm going to go, because I'm going to let you guys speak in Romanian. You've got lots and lots of people who probably want to speak in your language. So I've got enough information, and I've spoken to Emmanuel earlier. So I think it's a great project, and I'm on the list. As a UK guy. So
welcome on the list.
Awesome. Thank you.
First one on the list. Sold.
London Airport, get as close as possible, and then meet all you guys. But yeah. I'm going to leave you to it and let you speak in Romanian, so everyone feels more comfortable to ask their questions. Okay?
Thank you. Thank you so much. And see you soon on the property.